Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Jasmine and you're watching Jazzin' It Up, and happy New Year's to you all. I hope 2021 is gonna be a fantastic year for everyone and that we can just leave everything from 2020 in the past. I can only hope that everything is gonna get better this year. So today's video I have for you guys is my introduction to my new project pan. I always do project pans, one of my favorite videos to film and to watch. I love seeing people's progress and I do project pans that way I can keep using older items in my makeup collection and I don't neglect them because I'm always getting new makeup in and I don't want to just keep on grabbing for all the new fun makeup that I'm getting and just forget all the makeup that I had. So what project pans do is basically I push myself to use older products to either hit pan on them or to use them up completely. I do have an entire playlist on my channel that I will go ahead and link in the iCard for you guys. So if you guys would like to binge watch them, you're more than welcome to. But today is my introduction to my first project pan in 2021. This is going to be lasting for 3 months. That way I can do four projects in this year. So this will be lasting from January all the way till the end of March. I know I'm posting this a little bit after January 1st, but I did start using these products on January 1st. So let me go ahead and show you guys what I've decided to pan for this first project. So I didn't pick as many items to try to use up because I'm only going to be doing this for 3 months instead of 4 months. Maybe during my halfway mark I'll add in a couple items, but I've just picked 6 to start with. So the first item I have here is a lotion. I'm always adding in Bath & Body Works items because in the past, maybe like a year or so, it's been a while, I did a Bath & Body Works inventory and I realized how much Bath & Body Works I have. So I've been trying to go through it because I still purchase Bath & Body Works. I love testing out their new scents. I love their products, their lotions, their shower gels, literally everything Bath & Body Works makes. So I'm constantly buying them, but then I'm not getting rid of any of my old Bath & Body Works, so I'm trying to incorporate them into my project pans. So the first one I have here, this is the Pure Paradise. This is just one of their body lotions. I know this is a summer scent, but this is one of the oldest ones I have in my collection, so I want to try and use it up. I think I'm just going to be using this after I get out of the shower, lather myself in some lotion, and call it a day. I don't have too much in here. This is where I'm at right now. If you guys can see this black line, I know this lotion is a little bit everywhere because I was just shaking it up, but I don't have too much, just that much of products I have in here, so I shouldn't take me the entire 3 months to use this up because I usually put lotion on every single night before I go to sleep. So hopefully by the halfway mark I will be able to use this up completely, but we shall see. I love Pure Paradise. It is so fresh and clean. Oh, and it just smells so good. It smells like a little apple-y maybe. Very, very good. Highly recommend it. I don't even know if they have Pure Paradise anymore. But like I said, this is one of my older lotions, so maybe it is discontinued. But it still smells good, so I'm going to go ahead and finish this up before it does go bad. Next item I have here is a makeup item. This is a lip product. I know it's a little bit risky doing a lip product because people are still wearing their face masks and you don't even see them, like the lipstick. But I do wear lipstick when I go out during the weekends and when I'm at church. And I already sat down and everyone's already seated, then we can take off our face mask. So then people will be able to see my lipstick then. But also I just feel better wearing lipstick. So this is the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream and this is in the shade Abu Dhabi. So this is just a very cute little nude. Let me go ahead and swatch it for you guys. So I feel like this is almost done because it's starting to dry out. And the soft matte lip creams are so comfortable that I don't even mind if it's underneath a mask and if people don't see it, because it's just a basic nude shade. It's very, very pretty. Here is what the shade looks like. Abu Dhabi is what it's called again. Like I said, just a very cute nude. And it's super, super comfortable on my lip. So I hopefully will be able to use this by the end of the 3 months. It's getting a little bit dry when I'm putting it on, so I know it's coming to the end of its life. So hopefully I can be able to finish this in the next 3 months. Next makeup item I have here, this is the Wet n Wild Water Drop Primer. And this is in the coconut scent. I do not like this. It doesn't smell very good. I know it says it's supposed to smell like coconuts, but it smells like rotten coconuts. It is not a very pleasant scent at all. It is not my favorite. And it's very hydrating, which I did want a hydrating primer in my collection, but this is like water. Putting it on my face, like the water drop, I could totally get the name of that, but when I put it on my skin, it's like iridescence in it, like maybe a couple little glitter moments happening on my face, and I'm not really here for that. It doesn't make my skin very hydrated. It does it as I'm applying it, but then once it vanishes, it vanishes. I didn't feel like it moisturized my skin at all, so it's not my favorite. Like I said, I don't like the scent, not my favorite product, so I want to go ahead and finish this up. I think I used it maybe like once or twice, and I forgot to mark this, but it's maybe about here. I only used it a handful of times, so I'm gonna go ahead and mark this after the video, but I have a lot of product to go and I'm not very excited about it, but I did spend my money on it. I'm gonna use it up and I'm just gonna make it work. Next item I have here, I have a lot of makeup items, and this is the Santee. This brand you can get on the Shop Miss A website. This is the 2-in-1 concealer and foundation. I tried purchasing it in my concealer shade and I was obviously off. It's a very peachy toned shade. It works wonderful if you have like discoloration underneath your eyes, if you need to brighten that area a little bit, or as an eyelid primer. So let me go ahead and swatch this for y'all. So right here is the concealer shade. It may work as a concealer for some people, and this is what the concealer looks like, but it is not my perfect concealer shade. So like I said, I just use it as an eyelid primer, and I'm really having to scrape the sides inside of the tube to get the product out. So I know it's almost done. Hopefully I'll be able to use this by the end of the 3 months, but I only wear makeup usually during the weekends because at work I just don't have, I can't be bothered in the morning to put makeup on. But if I really push myself, I think I should be able to finish this by the end of the 3 months. Next item I have here is another little roll-on. If you guys have seen my past project pan, I had another one of these rollerball perfumes in that project. So it's the same brand, Refuge, and this is the Refuge Forever perfume. This is in the dark red little packaging. The one in my past project pan was in a light pink, and that one was very sweet and like vanilla-y almost. This one is like dark and sultry, and it smells very, very like adult lady. Very, very mature. It smells very good, and it's completely full, so I didn't mark it. I haven't even used this once before, but it smells really, really good, and hopefully in the 3 months I'll be able to use this entire rollerball. I've had this thing for like over 4 years now, and it still smells really good, so I want to go ahead and use it before it completely turns bad. So this one I want to use in its entirety. Last but not least, I have my sixth item here, and it is a foundation. I'm very scared to try and finish this off because I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to. So I'm really, really pushing myself here. But this is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Stick Foundation, and I have mine in the shade tan. This is how much product I have left. I know it's not a lot, but this is a lot when you're using it as a foundation. It's in the shade tan, like I said before, so I don't know if it's going to be my exact shade. I could probably use this maybe as a cream bronzer moment. I could probably mix it in with another foundation, but this stick foundation has lasted me forever. I've had this for over a year now, and I still have this much product left. So hopefully in 3 months, if I use this every time I wear foundation, I think I'll be able to use this up. But I really have to push myself. I'm really nervous about it, but I have faith in myself that I will be able to get this finished up. It is my goal to use this up completely because this is one of the oldest foundations in my collection, and honestly it's not my favorite. When I first got it, I really, really loved it. It was great during the summertime, but now I'm not really feeling this foundation anymore, so I want to go ahead and get it out of my collection. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. This was just the introduction to show you guys what items I'm picking for my first project pan of 2021. I'm super excited to be doing more project pans this year. Like I said, I love doing them, and I will have my latest project pan listed in the iCard for you guys. And like I said, I'll have the playlist in the iCard as well. If you guys aren't already subscribed to my channel, please do so. It is the red button down below. I do beauty related videos like project pans, empties, hauls, all that good stuff. And right next to the subscribe button, there's a little bell that you can click on to get notified when I upload new videos. It'll send a notification directly to your phone. And if you aren't already following me on Instagram, I have two of them. One is mine, it is Jazmin_up, and the other one is my business that I have for my desserts. It is Treats by Jazmin. Also, my Snapchat is listed down below for you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed your new year and your holidays, and I'll see you in my next video. Have a great day.